Saint Benedict is known as the father of the church's monastic tradition. He's also credited with forming the Christian roots of European culture and civilization. In celebration of Saint Benedict, Dr. Jem Sullivan, author of The Beauty of Faith, joins us to explore a painting housed in the National Gallery of Art here in Washington. The painting is titled A Miracle of Saint Benedict. Jem, welcome back to the broadcast.
Thank you for having me.
First, tell us about the painting that we're going to see and what miracle is being depicted.
Sure. You know, Saint Benedict lived from the years 480 to 550 AD, and since his death, the church has revered him as an outstanding model of holiness. He wrote a guide for monks and nuns that became famously known as the Rule of Saint Benedict. Mm. And that's the figure we see on the left side of this painting, Saint Benedict in his monastic cell with the traditional artistic attributes that are given to him, which is his abbot's staff that he has in his right hand, and the rule, his famous Rule of Saint Benedict, in his lap.
It appears when you look at the picture that the painting is sort of split in two. There's this column down the middle. Why divide the scene?
You know, it looks like it's two paintings, but in fact, it's really one scene that the artist is offering for our contemplation. Most of what we know about Saint Benedict comes to us from the writings of Pope Gregory the Great. In his second book of the Dialogues, he gives us a kind of biography of Saint Benedict, in which he describes many miracles, and this painting is one of those miracles. As the story goes, there was a young boy named Placidus who was living in the monastery where Saint Benedict was abbot, and he's sent to a nearby river to fetch water. And of course, the currents are too strong, and so he is drowning. Saint Benedict, sitting in his cell, senses that the boy's in danger. And so he calls one of his monks, Morris, to rescue Placidus from the raging waters. After the event, the boy tells the story, recounts the story, and says that at the very moment that he was being rescued, he felt the cloak of the Abbot Benedict overshadowing him. And so this is the miracle of Saint Benedict that we see in this beautiful painting.
It's incredible. What an incredible story. Why do you think the artist, who is anonymous, by the way, depicted Benedict in such a way, like you mentioned, with the staff and all of his attire?
It's really to tell us who he is, right? It's a visual kind of narrative, a visual gospel, these paintings. So he is the abbot that tells us he's the founder of Western monasticism, very important role. And then he's got his rule, his famous guide for monks and nuns. And really that tells us his importance, why he is important for the church, in the history of the church. The monks and nuns who followed Saint Benedict really transformed culture. Mm-hmm. Ora et labora, work and prayer. Prayer and work was the heart of the rule of Saint Benedict. And these monks and nuns would then transform medieval culture through prayer, manual labor, love of learning, and a life of virtue. So what they did was really rescue culture, their medieval culture, with the light of the gospel, the light of Christ, in the same way that this young boy is being rescued from the raging waters. So I think as we pray to Saint Benedict today for his mm-hmm. intercession, we can pray for that same fidelity to Christ and for the courage to transform culture through a new evangelization.
So many important values, both in this pain and learning about Saint Benedict, both historically and obviously as we can apply it to our own lives today. Dr. Jem Sullivan, author of The Beauty of Faith, thanks so much for telling us about this painting.
Thank you, Wyatt.